Hello, Umut here. Welcome to another video. Today I'm working on my art journal, Moleskine sketchbook I'm using. Today I will give myself a little challenge. You know, if you follow my channel, that I love big bold colors, and I always cover my art journal with color, and I don't leave any white space. But today I'm going to try to leave as much white space as I can. So I'm going to start with a little stamping on an empty page. I just used some gesso to clear the parts that I had a little bit paint. And I'm just stamping this little stamp that I have from ages ago. It's a text stamp, and you can use whatever you want, with an archival ink, just to give a little bit texture at the background. My focal point is from Elena Zinskia Art digital stamp. So I'm going to show you what I'm using. This is Misty and Mira digi stamps. And inside there is more than what I am using. That's why I wanted to show you. I'm going to use this girl, but not this one. But you have both and more, a flower heart and everything, both in colored and uncolored versions. You see this flower bouquet I will use, but this heart I'm not going to use. But you get it anyway, to use in many other projects. I quickly printed both my images that I'm going to use on a piece of white cardstock, regular one. And I used my inkjet printer. I'm going to use this stencil first to create a border, but it's really not necessary for you to have this stencil to create this border. I just saw it last minute, it was not my plan, but nevertheless I'm going to use it to create. It's just dashes that you could draw by hand as well. I'm just going over it with my Posca marker, and this Posca marker is an acrylic marker, so it's a very solid opaque color, but you can use any black marker, doesn't matter. I will just have a first border. I'm just going a little bit reverse in my process, because I want to, my challenge is to leave white space. So I'm not coloring my page yet, I'm doing other things. And this will be my composition. So I'm going to place my girl on one corner and the flower arrangements on the other corner. So I'm going to fussy cut my girl and the flowers now. Now that my fussy cut images are ready, I'm going to do some stenciling again using the same stencil. This is from Dilusions, by the way, a very old one. That I got when probably when I first started art journaling, and I'm going to use this Harlequin design together with black embossing paste. If you don't have black embossing paste, just mix your normal modeling paste with black paint or any other textured thing that you have, gloss paste, heavy gesso, you can use any. Or if you don't have anything, you can use heavy body acrylic paint. It won't give the same raised 3D texture, but it will raise and give you a texture for sure. Now I'm going to paint these images with distress spray stains. Actually, I'm going for a watercolor look, like an imperfect watercolor look that will be kind of monochromatic and very neutral. So I selected these. I didn't have these sprays before, so they are new. I'm going to use them as like watercolors. If you have watercolors, you can go for like neutral color scheme if you are replicating this page, and just dilute it with water to reach other colors. I could easily use watercolors as well. I'm just using tones of neutrals, beige, very light green, and brown. And I'm just spraying water just to dip my brush into this spray stain, which is ink, and dilute it with water. When I want to give shadows, I use more darker, and when I want to have highlights, I just dilute it with more water. I'm going to leave all the colors that I used down below at the description area, so you can see my color scheme. But as I said, in general, I'm going for a muted neutral look. So it's all like browns, darker brown, lighter brown, vintage photo, walnut stain, old paper, antique linen, this kind of colors that I'm using. I also included some grays in between, pumice stone, but you'll see all the colors down below anyway. With this project, as I said, I just wanted to challenge myself to do something different. From time to time, I use neutral colors or leave more white space. But maybe I can challenge you to try something new as well that you haven't done before or don't do regularly. It will certainly open your mind and give you new ideas, even if you don't change your usual style. It's sometimes nice to break the routine. I just colored my girl very easily, like I didn't fuss around all the details and stuff. I just wanted to give a little bit shadow and color it very easily. I'm not fussing over the flowers as well, not going to details. I'm just using different colors to cover it all. This kind of imperfection I think gives a very nice look. And I really like it, and there is a lot of variation in colors in terms of neutral colors as well. So I think it looks all good. I'm going to go around the edges as well to get rid of the white edges because of my fussy cutting with a black marker. And I'm using my glue stick to stick down my images because I used water-based colors, the sprays. It's going to smear, so I don't want to ruin my image and the white background. I have a white background, so I won't be able to take it back. Now that I glued them down, I'm going to do a little bit more of this Harlequin design on the right side of my girl as well. At the same time, I'm covering some empty space. I am also getting rid of this shoulder space that's a little bit empty, like from the fussy cutting, so I'm just covering a little bit of a flow there. So that's how you can cover your flows as well, or the images that you cut that doesn't look neat and tidy. You can do some designs over it, so no one sees the shoulder isn't complete there. And since I did all that design now, I'm going to give the same colors to my page that I used to color my focal points. I'm just using them directly from the bottles, and I'm spraying water to spread the colors over my page, treating them like watercolors basically. I'm letting the paint find its way more or less, sometimes manipulating it with a baby wipe, but using the same colors, going round and round. I'm mixing all these colors, grays, beige and browns, and a little bit very light green all over my page. I'm really happy how organic it looks, and this watercolory look that the page has. It looks like an old book actually, with the script at the back. Now that I am done and happy with the background, I'm going to do a couple of things using embellishments. Remember this part of the image that was hanging from the girl's hair? I'm just going to stick it back with a real chain to give a nice detail to the page. And also I'm going to place my sentiment into this metal frame that I had in my stash. So it says make a difference. I mean, according to me, I made a difference in what I was doing today, so I feel happy and I just wanted to use that sentiment. I'm using matte medium to stick down my metal embellishment, and I'm going to use a couple of brads to just give even more details that will look nice. That's why I always leave one page before, one page after empty, just in case I want to play with it and give details like this. I'm just poking it from these holes and I'm going to secure it on the other side using a couple of tapes so that it doesn't tear the other page. Now that everything is ready, I'm going to work on my border. I'm not going to leave it like this. I'm using my Posca pen again, the acrylic pen that I have, to draw solid lines after these dashes that I drew before. For this border, actually, I'm inspired by the polka dots that the hairband she has, the girl has. So I wanted to replicate it on the border to have some sort of harmony, combining that details on my border. So I'm just drawing it, painting it with black. And you can use your acrylic paint to paint it with black. And I'm using my, again, Posca pen in white to make some polka dots all around the border. Not only this gives a very nice definition to my page, you see the it looks like an old book that is open within that black border. Also, it creates a very good contrast with the rest of the page, the background, which is very neutral and very light. So this kind of details always makes your page pop. And lastly, I'm doing some splashes with black as well, with a very thin brush, so that I don't make big blobs of black spots, but a little bit detail to bring everything together. I really love this page so much. The girl is very nice. I love her from the moment I see. And the colors look like really an old book, which I really love. I hope you enjoyed it too. And I hope you join me in making something different than what you are doing normally. We sometimes need to break the routine. Don't forget to hit the like button, comment or subscribe to my channel if you like my videos. And don't forget to open the notifications. Also, if you follow me on Instagram, I make some different content, so I'd love to see you there as well. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.